Dude. Who the fuck is he, 12-year-old little bitch?
The fuck you say to me, you little shit?
Holy fuck.
How are you not in fucking school?
Dude, you must whoop your ass.
You kiss your mother with that mouth?
That was actually good. Dude.
Okay, to show that on Twitter, okay, because guys, the battle wasn't with Ninja, but chat.
XQCL.
Oh no.
Whatever.
You seem like you aren't informed, my man. Watch this informative video to get a grasp of things, PogChamp.
Hey YouTube viewers, Jessica Gatz here. I wanted to come to you guys today with a question I get asked a decent amount in my stream, and that is advice on being a streamer. So, essentially this video is also just my opinion on what you can do to be a successful streamer.
Step one, marry one.
Taken in a couple of different ways. Okay, so some people.
XQC vs NINJA, dude. Speaking about that, I fucking woke up to that shit. Kind of been my day. You already know. T1 loves some drama. T1 never a part of drama, but T1 do love some drama. It's a bit entertaining. Oh, hey, only thing I gotta say, dude. To be fair about all this charity bullshit, this is why I be telling y'all, motherfuckers. Fuck charities. How about that? I've been saying that for years, man. Dude, they're too. Charities in general, I just don't like. Because I want to. Kayla, consider the fuck I want. Kayla wants me to stop, but I've said this before. I feel like most charities don't actually know where your money's going towards, like going to, and I don't like that at all.
In case you guys don't know, this is a guy that I've literally been one of my best friends. I literally lived with him for over a month. I stayed with him. I went to fucking parties. I went to events. I went everywhere with him. We were literally stuck to each other like fucking glue at events. I was always talking to him about girls. He's always talking to me about girls. I literally told him, like, pretty much, there was a time where, remember, I was going through my depression and my anxiety shit, like last year, late 2019. Literally, I talked to two people the most about it. I talked to Ibrahim, my roommate, who's like literally my best friend. And then I also talked to Fed about it. Those are the only two people that I talked to about it. So that should show you how much I trusted him pretty much. And the fact that I feel like, I'm not going to go into it once again, but the stuff that I told him while I was depressed and anxious and like him helping me, the fact that he used the shit I told him against me and did shit that like made me more sad. I didn't know at the time, obviously, but I found out now that he did more fucked up shit than you can imagine. Like, it's something unforgivable. You can't go back and like.
Guys, what's a soft block? Oh, you block and unblock? Ah, whatever, dude.
T-minus 30 seconds.
Oh, thank you for watching. Cause he was following me literally 10 seconds ago. Yo, Ninja, my dude. Hey, Ninja, look, let me do it on Twitter, dude. Dude! Hey, baby!
15 seconds.
Hey! Get a load of this, baby!
People don't know what Tamago is. It's sweet egg. Very, like, one of the most common things you can get at any sushi place. It's great. Yeah, Tamago's great. So good.
What are you doing? And he's like, come here, like, let's cuddle. And I looked at him and I'm like, what the fuck? No. And he was like, no, come on, let's cuddle. And he's like, it's not that big of a deal. Let's just cuddle. And I clearly remember saying no. I clearly remember being uncomfortable with this. I don't cuddle with my guy friends, and I never have in my life cuddled with a guy friend before. Ever. I barely even cuddled with the guys I dated at that point. I never had any serious relationships. I just never found anyone to date seriously. Anyway, that's a story for another time. So I remember being very uncomfortable and saying no, and he eventually was very insistent, and so we cuddled. I was a little spoon, he was a big spoon. It was extremely awkward. I hated it. We never did it again.
No, totally. Like, are you free today at 2 p.m.? And I'm like, yes, that's in 3 hours. So he actually talked to me that day. And he's like, you don't need to pay. This entire situation is about people taking advantage of others. And when you're like this, how could I accept payment from you? You know what I mean? Like, it's the same shit. And he said that I won't accept money, but yeah, in the future I'll take your money, but like, for now, no. Like, he said he wanted to talk to me human to human, and he gave me a good perspective, and I really, really, really appreciate him talking to me. Very amazing person. Like, I am very thankful he carved out time to talk to me. It really helped me sort out my mind.
Don't open that can of worms.
Can I get a welcome to the jungle,
chat,
Mr. Cow?
How many do you need to build a portal? Is it 6?
QVC, you fucking sexist.
We're good.
Piece of
we're good
shit.
To go.
I bet you've never even gotten a victory.
We're good to go, baby.
Jesus Christ, you act like an anti-vax.
I should death Sunday. You on the bench, like the bus coming. Ain't nothing sweet but the swishers. I'm focused, might as well say cheese for the pictures. Oh, go Andre the Giant. You a sellout, but I ain't buying. Chopper dissect a nigga. Put it into your world like the
Mayans. It's a celebration, bitches. I said it, I'm done.
And then he... This is so strange for me to talk about on the internet. Oh my god. Anyway, this is so weird. He opened my legs and put his head on my crotch. I was wearing pants and everything, like... that just never happened to me before.
I mean, they got rid of the fat people hate. I was not really surprised that they got rid of fat people hate. The funny thing about that is that they got rid of fat people hate before they got rid of the racist subreddits. And people didn't understand why, and I can explain why. It's because the people on Reddit are fat and not black, right? That's really what it was. So it was more offensive to them personally, and that's why they decided to get rid of a fat-shaming subreddit before the racist ones. Let's be real. And I remember this is the first thing that other people...
I think calling him QVC was classless. I think XQC is never a man... You know the old Michelle Obama phrase, when they go low, we go high? That is not the XQC way. It is when they go low, we go lower, and we're warlord low. We're going way lower, way harder, way faster. He punches back. He does not punch up. He does not punch down. He just punches back. Always. Doesn't matter who takes a shot at him. It doesn't matter. He will never be like, you know what? It's not worth it. All right, I already handled this. You're being annoying. You're butting in. Nope. He's wolfing down 15 fucking pancakes, talking hella shit, ready to go live for 11 hours.